With the Fire Dragons portion of the Song of the Hero now behind us, there is a side quest we can now continue. You want to fly on over to the Pumpkin Landing, and you previously had to have broken the chandelier, delivered the soup to Aegis, carried the pumpkins to the shed, and then performed with Kina inside the Lumpy Pumpkin at nighttime. Once you've done all of that, you can go and speak with Kina outside of the Lumpy Pumpkin. So Kina needs help basically plowing the land so that they can plant more pumpkins. So who do you think would be best to help plow the land? I guess it involves a lot of digging, so why not a Mogma? That they seem like the perfect tribe. So you could use your dowsing ability and it'll lead you to the Elden Volcano region. You want to land at the Volcano East landing spot. At this point, you want to basically jump into the volcano. This is the same volcano that we came in basically the first time you first entered the Elden Volcano region. So ride the air geysers up and jump on down. You want to be careful here. You can use your dowsing mechanic right now if you'd like. But just like when we got a goddess cube earlier on in the quest, you need to sort of float on downwards and you need to land at the particular pillar that has the Mogma. And this is the same Mogma we met earlier on in our quest. So go ahead and speak with him. Alright, so we found the man for the job, or the Mogma for the job, and it's now time to return to Kina over at the Pumpkin Landing. So you can use the massive air geyser right over here to get back up, or to get outside of the volcano here in the middle of the Elden Volcano. And at this point, you want to just run on over to the nearest bird statue. There's a couple of them in the area, but I'm gonna just run over to the same one that I came into the area from, and return to the sky. It's worth noting that, you know, I've mentioned this before, you could have done the Song of the Hero quests in any order. You could go to the Lanayru region, the Faerun region, or the Elden region first, and if you went to the Elden region first, you could have done this Gratitude Crystal quest like before the Kikwa side quest I did a couple videos ago. It doesn't really matter. It's just this is triggered after the Fire Dragons portion of the Song of the Hero. And this is the last of the Gratitude Crystal quests, as long as you've been following along. So once you complete this, you should have all 80 Gratitude Crystals.
Whoa!
So after completing Kina's side quest, we now have all 80 of the Gratitude Crystals, meaning it's now time to return to Batero over at Skyloft to see what we did this all for. I mean, we sort of knew it was Batero's goal was to basically live amongst the residents of Skyloft without sort of being feared as being this like monster, evil, demon type person. So he wanted to become human. So once we've collected all 80 of these crystals, that'll, I guess, be enough gratitude to turn him human. However that works, I guess it makes just as much sense as collecting Skulltula tokens to turn spiders into humans. But I guess it's a reoccurring trend in Zelda. Anyway, first and foremost, for collecting 80 Gratitude Crystals, you get the most obnoxiously unnecessary item in the game, the Tycoon Wallet, which holds 9,000 rupees. And yes, if you have the extra wallets, you can hold over 9,000 rupees. Yeah, I did it. I guess Batero sort of looks human-ish. He still has those, like, devil horns. But, at this point, Batero can be found for the remainder of the game at the bazaar, and he sort of just mingles with the rest of the people. Or, well, I think he does. He's sort of just standing around, and you can go and talk to him there. Furthermore, there's no more enemies, even at nighttime, in Skyloft. That basically consists of the Choo-Choo and Keys. They won't be in Skyloft anymore. I guess Batero was sort of affecting them. But anyway, that's it for the side quest, or in terms of Gratitude Crystal side quest. So it's now time to progress in the main quest. And the third portion of the Song of the Hero is found at the Lanayru region. So I'm going to go ahead and I'll see you guys for the next video.